That baby shower, I'm gonna keep it 100. I didn't really like it. I was appreciative. It was like one big party and it was not about me. Body good is some of my them. Feels pretty, me a problem. Everything from Paris, Milan, straight off the runway when I grab them. Platinum plaques in my office. Turned that $1 million office. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, you should definitely subscribe because I'm a whole vibe, okay? Period. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing a pregnancy story time featuring my daughter. She did not want to cooperate today. She wouldn't even let me do her hair or anything, so she's not gonna really be in this video like that. So I'm gonna be doing a pregnancy story time. I have pictures and videos. I'm gonna be talking about everything from beginning to end, symptoms, from symptoms to my baby shower to my gender reveal, all that. I'm about to just put y'all on. Since I wasn't really on YouTube during that time, let's just start off at the beginning of my pregnancy. I have a how I found out video on my channel. You guys just kind of probably have to scroll down, or I'll just link it down below in the description bar. So I'm not gonna go into all of that. It's gonna go into like my first trimester symptoms and then kind of just build up to all the events that happen. First trimester symptoms, a lot of people tell me, and let me not say, a lot of my family tell me that I am lucky, okay? Because what some of them went through, like, I didn't go through any of that. Yeah, my glasses is like all the way down my nose down here because my eyelashes are mad long, but I wanted to wear my glasses in this video. So, yeah, a lot of my family members, they tell me how lucky I am because my first trimester, I wasn't sick or anything. I had very bad nausea, so I was nauseous all the time, especially like in the mornings on the drive to work. I was so nauseous all the time, but I never wanted to throw up because one thing about me is I do not like throwing up. And I feel like who likes throwing up, right? Right? But I have a fear of it, okay? And I don't even care. I'm not ashamed, nothing. You know how people have a phobia, like spiders, things like that? I have a phobia of throwing up. So that was one thing I was worried about when I found that I was pregnant. Nothing else, not about pushing. People always used to be like, you're not worried about pushing? No, girl, I'm worried about if I'm gonna be throwing up all day and every day or not. I was very fortunate. I was just very nauseous, never really threw up. I probably like gagged once, but that was about it. Okay, so my prenatals, like, I could not swallow pills for nothing. And then, of course, feeling nauseous, it just was not happening with me swallowing pills. So I was able to find liquid prenatal on Amazon. I'll insert a picture of the one that I used. Okay, y'all, so I just wanted to say, I think they changed the packaging because this is not the same packaging that I had when I was pregnant. Like, it looks completely different. But this is the same brand, so I think it's the same thing, and they just changed the packaging. Just in case anybody else is pregnant or, I don't know, you plan on getting pregnant or you just want to take prenatals. I use a liquid one now. Most people would be like, why wouldn't you rather take a pill? Because the liquid one didn't really taste good. It didn't really taste good. I used to just, me as extra as I am, I used to just hold my nose like this and take my prenatal daily and I was fine. So I used to hold my nose, take my prenatal like a big baby. I don't care, but I did it. Okay, if I could find the video of me attempting to take the prenatal pill that my GYN originally prescribed to me, I'm going to insert that video. It was so hilarious. I could not swallow that pill. My whole family was in the house kind of like cheering me on, trying to get me to swallow the pill, but I could not
swallow it. Dominic,
damn it, I couldn't record it
in 3 weeks.
Just relax. You think it too much, just relax. Drink.
Come on, you got this, you got this. No, you have to keep. You got it. Swallow, Domo. Swallow. You got it?
Okay, so moving on from that, I had went to a couple of my doc's appointments. I'm gonna show you guys some ultrasound. So she was just so tiny in there, like a little peanut. So yeah, went to a couple of those appointments. So moving on to like my second trimester, the nausea was pretty much gone. It was just a matter of feeling her kicking and all of that. It was just a crazy feeling, like you had a whole human inside of you, like moving around. It was crazy. I definitely was anemic before I was pregnant with her, but once I got pregnant with her, it was like even worse. Especially since, you know, pregnant, eating ice, that's like a thing, but I was really anemic. At one point, my doctor was telling me, you need to slow down on the ice, and you need to take iron pills. I was mad about that, but the iron pills are really, really, really tiny. I think they're called slow FE. I'll insert a picture of that too. But yeah, I had to take iron pills. But like I said, second trimester was pretty smooth. Look at this one. Then, was gender time. So I had an appointment and I asked my aunt to come with me to the appointment because I knew I wanted to have a gender reveal, like, type of party. Didn't know when I was having it, but I knew I wanted to have one. So I had my aunt come to my appointment with me. So my aunt came to my appointment with me and she found out the gender while I was there. Honestly, let me tell y'all. So shortly after that, my aunt told my cousin, which is her daughter, what the gender was, because them two were going to try to plan something. My child's father, he lives in New York. So since he wasn't going to be a part of the gender reveal regardless, he wanted to know the gender. So I'm like, sure, y'all could call him. Y'all could tell him the gender as long as nobody tells me the gender. So my cousin called him and told him the gender, right? So he tells his mother. So let me tell y'all this whole little situation that went down real quick. So he calls his mother and tells his mother the gender. Then his mother texts me. Look at this one. She texts me something. I can't remember the exact message, but he was in the message referring to my baby. So I'm like, I know this lady did not just tell the gender of my baby. Like, I know she did not just tell me the gender of my child when I told her specifically. I didn't want to know because I was having a gender reveal party. So, yeah, your grandmother. So I was livid, okay? But she actually genuinely made a mistake and said he. She said, like, when she refers to the baby, she was just referring to he in general. But she said she didn't mean anything by it. So my aunt said to them, they tried to calm me down. Like, you don't know if it's a boy or it's a girl. She just said he just because. But we're not saying it's not a boy. You know, they tried to just throw me off. But from then on, I was convinced I was having a boy. Okay? But I started looking at boy clothes. Even though I really, 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 really wanted a girl. Because I'm just real girly and I wanted a girl. So, yeah. Then moving on to gender reveal day. I decided to have, like, a joint gender reveal with my cousin. She was already having hers. So I was just like, why don't we just all make it one big event? So I asked if she was cool with it. She was cool with it. So we just had one big gender reveal event. So we was all eating. We was all eating. We had like a little game. We had like a little game where you basically predict the gender. And when, at the end of the game, I think it said we were both having girls or something like that. So it was time to find out the gender. So I didn't know how they were revealing the genders at all to either of us. Mind you, my portion of the gender reveal party was last minute because it wasn't the original plan for me to have my party with her. So they kind of came up with something at the last minute. So basically, we all went outside and they did me first. So when they did me, we just had the twisty things. I'm going to insert the video.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, yes. And when they did it, we found out that I was having a girl. So I was excited. Like, that same night, I was online shopping. I think that same night or the day after, I pretty much went shopping online. And then my cousin, she had, the way they revealed her baby was they had the blue powder come out of the exhaust pipe of a car. So she had a boy. So they're 2 months apart, by the way. So he's 2 months older than her. So yes, now moving on to third trimester, pretty smooth. I was just real big. I used to get swollen feet a lot, like to the point where I had to go to the doctor just to make sure everything was okay because it was so swollen. It was so much fluid in my foot and my ankles that if you was to touch my foot, like, the imprint of your finger would be in my foot. And apparently that's not a good thing, but I just had to get that checked out regularly. I couldn't be on my feet a lot because it would just be so swollen. And I'm talking about my ankles were fat. Like, my foot and my ankles were fat. Other than that, and besides me being mad big, because I was all belly. So I was mad skinny before I had a baby, and it was just belly. I didn't gain weight anywhere else. No butt, no nothing. Just belly. So then I flew to New York a couple of weeks later for my first baby shower. So the first baby shower was just basically her father's side, and I'm from New York, so also my friends that were in New York were able to come, and a couple of my family members flew out there with me too. So I'm gonna insert some videos of the baby shower and things like that. That baby shower, I'm gonna keep it 100. I didn't really like it. Like, I was appreciative of them throwing it for me, but to be honest, it was just it was like one big party, and it was not about me. Like, like I said, my majority of my family was not there. Only like two of my family members flew out with me. And then I have a couple of friends that came. I don't have that much friends because I keep my circle real small, real tight, real, you know. It was basically just one of my female best friends, one of my male best friend. I only have one male best friend, which is her godfather, came. I have very few friends that came. He brought his girlfriend, so very few people came from my side. It was mostly her father's side. So it was like one big party. So everybody was turning up drinking. None of his friends, a few of his friends acknowledged me, but majority of them did not acknowledge me. Y'all, that could be a whole story time in itself if y'all want it. But I mean, they didn't acknowledge me. Nobody came up really and said congratulations besides a few people that I still keep in contact with today from his side. Like, it was just one big party. It was a whole bunch of females there that he didn't even know that literally just came because they knew it was going to be a whole bunch of niggas. Her father has mad friends. Like, so it was just one big party. I was not happy at all. But they showed up and showed out as far as gifts. Because from that baby shower, I had diapers for the longest. I still have some diapers from them. But that baby shower, they did show out with the gifts. I just wasn't showered. They didn't play any games. Like, they have one game with like musical chairs, but it was really no games. It was really like no, I wasn't involved in anything. Like, you know how they usually have the games where you guess the size of the mother's belly, things like that. I wasn't involved in anything, so I was not really happy about that. At the end of the night, I was pissed at you, whatever. So then we flew back to Atlanta. I live in Atlanta, by the way, for those y'all don't know. We flew back to Atlanta, and then a couple of weeks later, we had my baby shower for my family in Atlanta.
So I'm ready. They're not telling me the theme, but they bought my dress, so I'm assuming it's like Hawaiian because her name is Alani.
Obviously that was more my style. Majority of my family is in Atlanta, but it's not that many of us. Like, it is a lot of us. Like, we have fun by ourselves, don't get me wrong. Like, we have fun all the time when we have our event. It wasn't really the party atmosphere because it's really just a family setting. So that one was 100% better. Obviously, I didn't get that much gifts because it was just my family. You know what I'm saying? So they helping me out to this day, so it really don't matter. Baby shower theme was a luau because her name is Alani. And let me tell you how I picked out her name. So she's going through so many names. And one of the names I really liked was Sahai. And my cousin liked it too. I don't remember why we didn't go with Sahai. But I really like Sahai. But I was on... Sorry if I'm talking with my hands a lot. Yeah, I do that. I'm used to having nails too. So, yeah. Something just told me to go on like Google. And I was searching names for the longest. And I would just ask like family and friends what their opinions were. And I came across like Hawaiian name site. And the name was actually... I think it was actually Alani or Ilani. It was something along those lines. But for some reason, my slow self was pronouncing it Alani the whole time. And then when my aunt realized the spelling, she was like, I don't think that's pronounced Alani. But I was already set on Alani. So I was like, her name is Alani. But that's pretty much how I found her name. And I wasn't looking for Hawaiian baby names. It just came up on Google. Like, I didn't type in Hawaiian baby names. I didn't even think about a Hawaiian name because I'm not Hawaiian. And her middle name is Lene. So Alani Lene. And I think Lene just came about just because it just rang off the tongue. Like, Alani Lene just flows so perfectly. So that's where that came from. But, okay, so I do have a labor and delivery story time up. But I will go into, like, my labor and delivery from what I can remember. So a couple weeks later, I went into labor. It's crazy because I went into labor literally 24 hours before they were going to induce. Then I was in labor for a while. I was stuck at, I don't remember how many centimeters. You'll probably have to go and watch my labor and delivery video. But I was stuck at something centimeters for a while. And they were telling me like if I didn't progress, I was going to have to get induced. So I was kind of happy that I kind of progressed on my own. I was able to get epidural really, really early. So I was happy about that. I was real nervous about epidural. But like I said in my labor and delivery video, didn't hurt at all. Once you're in that moment, trust me, you're not gonna move because you don't want to be paralyzed. So, and then I also had a nurse. She was really, really nice, and she helped me kind of stay still. So I did not look at the needle when the anesthesiologist came in. So I don't know how big it was. I heard it's big as shit. There it was. I had to get a C-section. Was not planned or anything. There was nothing wrong with me. The only problem was she was head down. Everything. So she was head down. But her face was down. There we go. I think her face was down. So her face was facing downwards. So when I was pushing the back of her head, kept hitting my pelvic bone, so she couldn't come through.
Come on. Mama.
Yep.
Yep. There you go. This is the time to do it.
3, 4, 5, 6.
I was pushing for a while, and she was not coming out. So they just had to go ahead with the C-section. And let me tell you, I was scared out of my damn mind. I was crying, all that stuff. Nobody wants to get cut open. And let me tell y'all, that C-section, you feel the pressure. Like, people say it don't hurt. You just feel pressure. But the pressure hurt me. And I'm not saying this to scare anybody. I'm just giving my experience. That pressure hurt. Like, obviously, I didn't feel the pain, but that pressure really hurt. Because it just felt like they were just yanking and pulling and yanking. And it's crazy because it was the weirdest feeling when they cut me open. Like, you can't feel the pain, but you feel it. After the C-section, I think we were in the hospital for about 2 days, maybe 2 or 3 days. And then, let me tell you, in the hospital, she was a crybaby. She was really, really loud. She was one of the loudest babies on the floor. Like, they knew when Alani was crying. Because she has this high-pitched, distinctive cry. That's why I think she's going to be a singer. But we ain't going to get into that. I think my baby going to be a singer. After having her, it was pretty much smooth sailing. It was just a matter of getting used to waking up so much, changing diapers, because I've never changed a diaper in my life before her. Don't have any younger siblings. I was never around any of my younger cousins when they were babies, because I was living in New York and everybody was in Atlanta. So, like, I've never changed a baby diaper before my daughter. So, yeah, it was just a lot to get used to. But the healing time, it took, I think, like, what, 6 weeks? 6 or 7 weeks. But yeah, I think that's pretty much it, y'all. I feel like I was chatting, but that's like my whole pregnancy in a nutshell. It wasn't really difficult or anything, thank God, because I've heard some stories about pregnancies. But yeah, for the most part, she's been really good. Like, she would sleep through the night, well, obviously, except when she was hungry. And I also breastfed her, so yeah, I would just feed her and she'll go right back to sleep. It was never like, I know some babies wake up in the middle of the night and they're up. She was never like that, and she's still not like that to this day. She'll wake up to eat and go right back to sleep. Like, hopefully I enjoyed this story time. Don't forget to subscribe, because I'm a whole vibe, like I always say. Like, we're good vibes over here. But yes, thank you guys for watching this video. I'll see you guys in the next one.